Welcome to Mastering Solutions. This drag problem, I'll be totally honest with you, is a pain in the butt. It sucks. But the reason is because it's really just an algebra problem, a wolf in sheep's clothing hiding as a physics problem. Now, of course, we got this. Like, we'll work through it together, obviously, but I totally understand the frustration. If you try to work this problem out by yourself, it's pretty difficult, actually. But it's a cool problem in the sense that it allows us to see algebraically what's happening in this situation. But as far as the concept of the physics, it's really just all algebra. So first, before we dive in, let's draw a free body diagram for this situation. So we have the skydiver, they're falling currently. And so weight obviously is pulling them down. And the only other thing that's going to be acting in this situation is drag. So the drag, or as we're falling through air in this case, you can think of it is a fluid. It's not a fluid, but it has properties of fluid dynamics. So here we have drag force. So if we sum the forces in the y direction, we have drag going in the positive y direction minus weight. And it's in dynamic equilibrium because at terminal speed, what does that even mean, right? Terminal speed means that we're not speeding up anymore. So weight is pulling us down. That's not going to change. But the drag is now equal and opposite to the weight. So they're counterbalancing each other. So the drag isn't greater and the weight isn't greater. And we're falling at the same constant speed. But we're not at that point yet. We're at 1/2 of the eventual terminal speed. So we are accelerating in the y direction still. So it's going to be equal to mass times the acceleration in the y. So this, of course, can be mg. So d minus mg is equal to mass times the acceleration in the y direction. So let's isolate the acceleration. We'll divide both sides by m. Let me come up here. So we have acceleration in the y direction is equal to d minus mg over m. Now, we're going to leave this here for a moment. This is the equation that we'll use at the end. But now comes the tricky spot of figuring out what the drag component is. So drag, as we already talked about, when we reach terminal speed, d is going to equal mg. That is the definition of terminal speed right there. But drag, we can break it up as 1/2 the coefficient of drag times the rho, which is the density of air. This is a Greek letter rho that we use to represent density. And then we multiply it by the area times the velocity squared. So this whole thing is d. But for the situation, we want 1/2 of the eventual terminal speed. So right here, let's just say that is v term, but we want to divide it in half. So if you divide something in half, it's obviously divided by 2, or you could say we multiply it by 1/2, right? So we have 1/2 c sub d rho a, and then we have v term divided by 2 squared. But as we just talked about, we'll have 1/2 c sub d rho a. This is saying the exact same thing, v term squared. So now for the algebra, let's carry over the squared into the parentheses. So we'll have 1/2 coefficient of drag times rho a. And then now we'll have 1/2 squared is 1/4 times v term squared again. All right, so since we have this, I chose to write it this way because now what we can do is let's pull out the 1/4. So we have 1/4 times 1/2 c sub d rho a times v term, the terminal velocity squared. And now, since we were able to pull out that 1/4, you can see this right here is exactly what we started with for drag. So now we can plug that back in. So 1/4 times drag. So what we'll do here is let's plug this in for when we're at the half of the terminal velocity. Let's plug it into this relationship right here for the terminal velocity. So we have 1/4 d is going to be equal to 1/4 mg. And another way of writing it is mg over 4. Exact same thing there. All right, so now this is equal to d, right? So now instead of plugging mg in, when we're at 1/2 of the eventual terminal speed, we're going to plug in mg over 4 for d. So now let's come up here and we'll do that. So a sub y is equal to mg over 4 and then minus mg divided by m. Here's some more algebra for you. We have a sub y is equal to, let's move this fourth out to this. So really we should have plugged in this one here, the 1/4 mg. So we have 1/4 times mg minus, now we are going to be minusing a fraction here, but this is an assumed 1, right? So 1 we could also say is 4. So 4 over 4 times mg divided by m. And so a sub y is going to be equal to 1/4 minus 4/4 is equal to negative 3/4 mg divided by m. The m's will cancel. And so let me scroll down a little bit here. So a sub y is equal to negative 3/4 times gravity. So we went through all of that, and it's interesting because what we just proved mathematically is that for this question, the mass of the skydiver doesn't matter. The area, all these different things don't matter. We can use all that we did to find the acceleration of the skydiver just by using gravity. So the acceleration of the diver at that instant when he's at 1/2 the terminal velocity does not depend on how much he weighs. It doesn't depend on all this other stuff. Acceleration in the y direction is equal to negative 0.75 times 9.8 meters per second squared. So we have the acceleration is a negative 7.35. In the question, they asked for the magnitude, so we'll just round that to 7.4 meters per second squared. They don't ask for the direction, so we'll leave it positive. If they ask for the direction and the magnitude, then it would obviously be a negative because we're going in the negative y direction. But this is the answer for the question, and at 1/2 the terminal velocity, the acceleration, the magnitude of it will be 7.4 meters per second squared.